What follows is an important message from EWTN in Ireland.
Hello, I'm Archbishop Eamon Martin of Armagh. Ireland is at a critical moment. Our government has decided to make it lawful to deliberately kill unborn children, claiming that this is needed to save the lives of women. Women and children deserve better. We need to do everything we can through prayer and action to overturn such unjust laws.
As a father and a grandfather, I have watched my family grow. I've marveled at the beautiful scanned images of my grandchild before he was born. And I know what it's like to lose a child. Our children need every care and protection throughout their lives, especially in those moments when they are most vulnerable.
As a nurse and a midwife and a mother myself, I know what it is like to be with mother and baby during a difficult pregnancy. It is absolutely essential that we offer them the best possible care we can.
As a young woman, I didn't have that care. I had a crisis pregnancy and I was told an abortion would help me. This so-called choice turned my life upside down. After the abortion, I wrestled with suicidal feelings which have taken years and the grace of God to overcome.
Only a few months ago, the Irish government promised that the welfare of the child would be paramount in our laws. We also have clear laws in this country against the reckless endangerment of children. And yet, under this abortion legislation, unborn children can be killed or left permanently disabled. We can't allow this unjust law to go unchallenged.
Without any time limits on abortion, this legislation is even worse than the British 1967 Act, which has already claimed over 7 million lives to date. That's hundreds of babies killed every day.
Dr. Trevor Hayes, who's an obstetrician in Kilkenny, told me that whilst working in a Scottish hospital, he saw the green forms for abortion already pre-signed by doctors before they had even met the women. How quickly the culture of respect for human life can be lost when abortion is legalised.
I meet women all the time through our healing retreats, so many broken and traumatised, wishing if only they could turn back the clock.
The Irish Constitution upholds the right to life of both mother and child as equal, yet this legislation breaks that sovereign pledge, leaving the unborn child defenceless in law, with no one to uphold his or her basic human rights.
I can't help thinking that those who promoted this legislation have forgotten that the unborn child is an actual human being with needs and rights like any of us. To deny the right to life of even one human person is to undermine the very foundations of society. Every human life is sacred.
We want to ask you to join us in prayer. We need a miracle.
At this time, many people all over Ireland are praying for the protection of human life. We ask you to spread this call to prayer to others.
We ask the special intercession of Our Lady as we take this petition to the Rosary.
And I want to encourage you to offer Friday fasting and penance for the cause of life. Remember, Jesus told us that some evils can only be overcome by prayer and fasting. So please join us in prayer, and God bless you always.